this period of lockdown, one of our favorite pastimes is watching Netflix. The viewers especially fall in love with the content that Netflix is continually able to produce, and some of our favorite movies and television shows are available there. What we like even more are the Netflix's recommendations. As soon as we open Netflix, its homepage provides a curated set of shows and movies based on our preferences. Or have you noticed how it again recommends more movies or series which you might be interested in after you finish watching on the platform? Isn't it surprising to see how a media platform can entirely understand our liking, remember it, and give suggestions, which we happen to love all the time? The funny thing is, we never told Netflix about our preferences. After some research on Google, I discovered that the magic of Netflix is owing to something called machine learning. That sounded deceptively simple. A machine that learns about your preferences based on your viewing history and those of others like you. But which machine? Where is it? How does a machine learn anything? Who are the people like me, and how does the machine know them? Does the machine learn in a day, or in 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, how many days? Well, that was an interesting offset to explore machine learning. I decided to dig in a little deeper, and here's what I understood. As I explored the internet, I learned that machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence, which we call AI, that provides systems the ability to automatically learn and improve from experience without being explicitly programmed. It is almost like how humans grow up learning from various situations in life. Learning cycle has three main components: observation of data, which can be behavior or inputs, memorizing the data, and learning. Let's suppose one of your very close friends broke your trust. You will not be able to trust others very easily and will always behave based on your past experience. Similarly, machines also work based on what input or instruction you gave and its previous learning, which makes better decisions in the future based on the examples that we provide. While we have been witnessing several powerful technologies in the last few years that incorporate artificial intelligence as well, but the question still remains in our minds. How are machines able to learn? We humans are blessed with a brain and memory that allow us to think and remember things. But how does a machine learn? So let me reveal the secret. Netflix's recommendation engine does this job. All it needs is to know you better to be effective with its recommendations. Therefore, the information it collects and integrates is a critical aspect of the process. This can be the information about your past activity, ratings, reviews, and other information about your profile, such as gender, age, or investment objectives. These then combine with the information such as the device which you use for access, the clicks on any link, location, and dates. The more data you can make available to the machine learning algorithms, the better the recommendations will be. Basically, a subtle combination of predictions and filtering makes hybrid recommendation engines like that of Netflix possible. But what kind of predictions and filtering? Of course, predictions about users' taste and filtering based on rating on the content. Let's understand this with a simple example. Have you ever shopped on Amazon? Well, Amazon and Netflix are both considered to be the winners of Attract with Customized Service battle. Amazon always suggests stuff to its users, not only on the website, but also through emails and messages. Yes, I'm talking about those pick your winter style or Amazon has your favorite clothing on sale messages that we receive all the time. Very powerful personalization tools are used for this because it is a great way to do discovery, meaning showing people items that they will like but are unlikely to discover by themselves. Pop-ups and recommendations on any page improve a visitor's experience by offering relevant items at the right time and on the right page. you must have come across the people usually buy these together section also. It comes right before the checkout. This filtering is based on the assumption that two users who liked the same product in the past will probably like the same ones now or in the future. Whoa, that is very intelligent. After this, structures like Venn diagrams, which are also called algorithms and graphs, are used to optimize these predictions and forward it as suggestions to the viewers. And there it is! Ta-da! As a form of facilitating personalized experience to customers, Amazon's fantastic revenue growth has been built on successfully integrating recommendations across the buying experience from product discovery to checkout. Netflix is doing the same job, making recommendations by comparing the watching and searching habits of similar users, which is also called collaborative filtering, as well as by offering movies that share characteristics with the films that the user has rated highly, which means content-based filtering. So every time you visit Netflix and watch something, Netflix collects the data to update the algorithm. The more users watch, the more data is collected to improve the algorithm. It is almost like someone is constantly observing your moves to keep a track of what you like and what you dislike. Or you can think of it as humans learning about each other's liking, whether in food, clothing, or genre of films, in a period of time by careful observation and memory. Recommendation engines do this rather comprehensively because they have to search a large amount of data for so many users. We started with a question, the answer to which we have found. Now, we also know that the scope of probability is not limited to a chapter of your mathematics textbook or to your syllabus, but it is the basis for such intelligent systems which are momentous for digital applications. Given that no human but a non-living invisible algorithm is so committed to understanding our likes and activity, humans fall in this trap very easily and companies gain huge profits. It is just that Netflix is doing it the best. It is indeed appreciable how Netflix carefully collects data from user activities, whether on Netflix platform itself or through tags in social media posts, and carefully optimizes options for us. Netflix's recommendation engine is tuned for hyper-specific categorization that can match tiles to the exact people who would be interested in them. And this is why it is earning huge profits, as cancellation rates are negligible. We just can't resist watching shows after shows on Netflix platform. Well, as much as it looks fascinating, we need to understand what binge watching can do to our minds. Are we going to Netflix and chill all the time just because this service is personalized? I have to say, a balance has to be achieved where we can enjoy the solace of technological progressions but not become a victim of its unfortunate consequences. Make sure you understand your needs and wants before you are tempted by a new recommendation by nobody else but a machine. So, be wise while you make your choices. Thank you for joining us in this lecture. We hope you enjoyed this one. Do feel free to post your questions in the discussion forum. We will see you in the next lecture. Thank you. Bye-bye.